Hello, hello, hello. How we doing, Sid?
Everyone. Hi, Corey.
Hey, so today is week three. Is it week three or week two?
Week two. Yeah,
Oh, I'm ahead of myself. See?
we've been having so much fun.
We're having so much fun. It's very, very easy to get ahead of yourself. But today is week two of our target class. We have another very fun session for you today. I am Coach Corey. This is Coach Sid. And we will get it started. So before we do that, like we do every week, we're going to do every week is we're going to start off with a nice exercise, a way to get the body going and jumping, ready to make some good swings. So let's Gary get that loaded up and see if we can have a little bit of fun. So let me find out where that is. Oh, I see it. Today is indeed wacky dress day, and you're going to see some wacky stuff.
Yes,
To
definitely.
say the least. Say the least. Okay.
Hey, my first TS Central Ohio Target class. This is Coach Corey. Me and the kids are coming at you with another video about exercise. This time we have wacky dress day, and we're gonna be doing a dance party. So get ready to do some of your favorite moves with us. And also, we have a special guest. Keep your eye out. Are you comfortable? Right there, right there. Let the groove get in. There, there, right there. Are you comfortable? Right there, right there. Let the groove get in. There, there, right there. Are you
Who
comfortable?
taught this
Right
kid how
there,
to
right
dance?
there.
I have no
Groove get
idea.
in.
I
There,
have no
right there.
idea.
Are you comfortable? Right there, right there. Let the groove get in. There, there, right there. Are you comfortable? Right there, right there. Let the groove get in. There, there, right there. Are you comfortable? Right there, right there. Let the groove get in. There, there, right there. Are you comfortable? Right there, right there. Let the groove get in. There, there, right there. Are you comfortable? Right there, right there. Let the groove get in. There, there, right there. Are you comfortable? Right there, right there. Let the groove get in. There, there, right there. Are you comfortable?
Yes, that is our little dance party that we did. If you want to call that dancing, but we had a good time. You know, even Brutus wanted to come in and make a
Yeah.
little guest appearance, say what's up.
I mean, that's an awesome way, especially during this time where, you can't go a lot of places and get some exercise. So just doing that, even in the kitchen or in the backyard, I mean, that's a great way to stay active and get outside.
Yeah, I think it is. You know, the kids had a good time dancing around, and they love the idea of getting Brutus involved. So it
Yeah.
was fun. It was fun. All right. So we also have our core value. We have two core values today. We have courtesy and integrity. I will tackle courtesy, and then Sid will come back and tackle integrity. So for courtesy means being kind and polite to others. It's very, very important. It goes back to that saying, treat people the way you want to be treated. Right. So my son and I, actually my whole family, but my son and I really, really ad adopted this this act that we do. So people tend to see homeless people on the side of the road and they don't like to give as much. Not everybody, there are people who do that, but we try to do it every single person. And our philosophy is if we ever are in need, hopefully somebody will give to us the way we give to others. So we're always giving, whether it be water bottles, food, anything like that, to people we see who are homeless. And I'm very proud to say that he really enjoys doing that, giving to others. So always try to make sure you treat people the way you want to be treated, because you never know. You may be in a situation where you thought you'd never be in to where you need help. So
Definitely.
always, always, always treat people the way you want to be treated.
Yes, I think
Okay.
that's an awesome example.
Yes. All right. So then we have our golf skill as well. So last week's golf skill, we went over, Lincoln and I went over a little bit about putting and what he learned, and he saw him hit some shots. Today, we're going to get into a little longer of a swing. It's called the Y to Y swing. And I'm going to explain to you why it is called just that in one moment.
Hey everybody, how we doing? Welcome to week two of the posture, grip, and alignment. Today, we're going to focus more on the Y2Y swing and the proper grip alignment for that. So why is it called the Y2Y swing, aka chipping? It's because when you're at a dress, the clubs and the arms form a lowercase y.
So like I just said, when you're at a dress, and what a dress means is when you're about to hit the ball, you're lined up to hit the ball, everything is in shape. Now that's when you can truly see the Y to Y swing as illustrated right here. So when I'm about to hit the ball, my arms and the club form a lowercase y.
You go back Y and through Y. You're trying to maintain the Y throughout your whole swing. In order to do that, you have to make sure your lower body turns just a little bit, nothing crazy. But just a little bit. For instance, when you go back Y, when you're going back to other Y, your body turns and actually releases the club with your body and not your arms. If you do not turn your body, the outcome is going back Y, through Y, yes, but the club face opens up a little more and it pushes your shots to the right, or you may actually hit it on the heel up.
Now, most people, especially at the target age, that is not their common problem. But the next thing I'm going to say is the common problem and what I see a lot of young people do. So make sure you pay attention to this part that I'm about to say.
The club or the housing. And then in other instances, you go back Y to Y, not have your lower body move, and you'll flip it over.
Yes.
And we don't want a lot of breakdown. So there are a couple of grips that you can try.
So like I said, the Y to Y breaks down a lot with target kids, with younger kids. And what that basically means is when your upper body or your lower body stops moving, the club flips over and you want to try to maintain that Y the whole time. So this angle that you see from right here, you want to maintain that the whole way through, back Y and through Y. And that is a chipping motion. It's how to get the ball up in the air. So what I want you to do is, if you don't have a club or a ball, by all means, let us know. We would love to drop some off to you. But what I would like you to do is get a club. You can get a stick or anything that you have around the house, a broom. And I want you to focus on going back. Find your Y to Y stance. Get your Y and think back Y through Y. Back Y through Y. And see how it looks.
Y. And from there, on the heel, one that fits you best as of right now. Why not have your lower body move and you'll flip it over? And we don't want a lot of breakdown. So there are a couple of grips that you can try. Find which one that fits you best as of right now. You have the interlock, which is the one I prefer. You have the overlap grip and you have the 10-finger grip.
Now, as of right now, the grip all the way to the right is more than likely going to be the grips that most young people use, and that's A-okay for right now, to have all the fingers on the club, like actual baseball bat. That is a perfect, that's absolutely okay right now. Don't worry about it. And if people tell you that it's wrong, then shame on them, because it's definitely not.
All of them are fine for you right now. Just make sure you find one that's best for you and make sure hands are close together. Okay, now let's talk about the alignment portion of our posture grip alignment from Y to Y, aka chipping. So we're still going to use the same exact train track model that Coach E used for putting. We had to adjust our train track just a little bit because when it comes to the Y to Y, aka chipping, you're not really releasing the club, turning the club over. The club stays open just enough to have a very nice, crisp hit. So
if you look at what I'm talking about, the railroad tracks, right? So when you're aiming for a ball, see those two alignment rods and how they're side by side. So that's exactly how you aim in a golf swing. Your shoulders are on one track and the ball's on another track. So, but those tracks are parallel all the way through, which means that you don't want to have your feet in one direction and the club in a different direction. You'll cross paths, and that's never good for a golf swing.
All actuality, you must aim a little left of the target.
So we're properly aligned.
Ball position should always be in the back of your stance. Very, very important.
I want to keep my proper posture, my feet a little close together, the ball in the back of my stance, my hips back, slight bend to my knees, and I'm in my Y. And from there, again, like last week, Coach E, it's a tick-tock motion.
Ooh. All right, so you see that the very end, the small swing. So this swing, this chipping motion, is a small swing. You don't want a very long one. This is generally used, the wide-to-wide swing is generally used around the greens.
Wealthy view to Pebble Beach for this 100th U.S. Open.
Pebble Beach, what are you talking about? So, yes, make sure you use the wide-to-wide swing around the green. But enough of that golf skill stuff. Let's get into the fun stuff, and that's another core value. And Sid has a very cool craft to show you. What's it?
I do. All right, so our next core value is integrity. And integrity, how I like to think about it, I'm going to use a little story like Corey did too. So I am actually a tennis player. I love golf too, but I played tennis all growing up since I was a little kid, all the way up to college. So one thing I like to think about all throughout my career is that, and it also applies to golf too. So, you know, you would have tough matches and it was always so important to go up after your match to the net and shake your opponent's hand, even win or lose. So I think that is one of a good example of integrity. So, you know, it may not have gone your way, but you're still a good sport. And, you know, that applies to golf in the same way, you know, telling whoever you're playing against in your group, you know, nice shot. That's also a good example too.
Yes. That's it. Am I? I heard her echo for some reason. I don't know. People, I'm out there, but it's okay. The coolest people are out there. Remember that.
You're still getting used to all the technology here at the first tee.
It's a lot harder than what you think, you know? It really is. So now we have the craft to pull up. Sid has a very, very wonderful craft that we're going to get into. Let me find it. I think I did not find it.
This craft also ties into our core values this week, and it's something you can do today or you can do it, you know, sometime this week, whenever. You can make as many or just one as you want. So it's an awesome one to do while, you know, you're taking a break from your schoolwork.
Got it. Ready? Coach Sid, take us through the craft.
Hi, everyone. Welcome back to Target.
Once you can see it. Hold on. Once you can see it. There we go. Is that better?
Yeah, got it.
Got it.
Hi, everyone. Welcome back to Target class. We're so excited you're joining us for another week, and that means another fun craft. Another fun craft. Like I said, I'm Coach Sydney, and I'm going to be walking you through today how to do make flowers with our handprints. So to start off, you're going to need paper, scissors, tape, a straw or a popsicle stick, some markers, crayons, color pencils, whatever you want to use to decorate, even paint. And you might need your parents or a sibling, older sibling's help with this to cut out your handprint because you are using scissors. So whatever your rules in your house are for that. So we're going to start out, pick any color, and you can also use colorful paper too. I unfortunately didn't have any at my house, so I'm just using some plain paper, which totally works too. You're going to place your hand down and go ahead and trace your hand just like this between all of your fingers and back around Perfect. Okay, and then just go ahead and connect these. And then you're gonna take your scissors, or your adult is gonna help you with the scissors, and go ahead and cut out, just follow that line that you just traced. Cut this out. A little tricky getting around all the fingers. Don't want to cut any off. Out of side, and just gotta finish up doing the bottom part. Okay, so there's my handprint, and this is gonna be the main part of the flower. So now go back to your piece of paper, or get another piece of paper, a different color, whatever you want. You can even get a different marker. Then you're gonna put just your thumb down and trace just around your thumb, and then connect those lines and do another one. And these are going to be your leaves. So let's go in, and again, maybe asking an older sibling or a parent to help you cut this out so we stay safe. That out. One more really quick. Then you're gonna put just your thumb.
Is that the wrong one?
And trace just around your thumb.
I feel like it's doing the same thing twice, right?
Connect those lines.
I think it repeats a little bit right here.
These are gonna
I'm
about to
say, I'm pretty sure.
So let's go in, and again.
It did. This is the wrong freaking video. I thought there was music playing still. Like, what's going on?
So we stay safe. That out. One more really quick.
So right now you're seeing the importance of these leaves. You're seeing it twice,
yes.
Right? It's very,
very important.
To get the leaves.
All right, hold on to the paper. You can set that aside. Recycle that later. Okay. So now this is the fun part. So you can use whatever you want: colored pencils, markers, crayons, paint if you want, and go ahead and just design your handprint. You know, do some squiggly lines, however you want. Just color these in like that, however you want. Be super creative with that. I'm not going to color the whole thing right now, but maybe later. but that's just to show you guys. So then, oh, and don't forget to color your leaves too. So then we're going to go ahead and attach your hand to your straw, popsicle. This is a reusable straw that I just had laying around in my kitchen, so you'll definitely be able to find something. And then go ahead and get your tape and just place that right on the back of your hand flower, just like that. Take your leaves, you can put them wherever you want on the stem, like that. So this is how it looks so far.
Cool.
Super pretty. I'm gonna attach the last one. One leaf, two leaf, three leaves, whatever you want. However you want your flower to look. So that's what it's gonna look like. Obviously, I bet your guys will be a lot more decorated than mine, but for the sake of time, just wanted to give you an outline of how to do it. So you can keep making these, make a couple of them, make 20 of them, whatever you want. And this really ties into our core value because, you know, this is something I could give to my mom or one of my sisters or something like that, you know, just as a little gift. And that's all about what courtesy is talking about. You know, that's just doing the little things for other people and, you know, just being kind to them and thinking of others first is really all about courtesy. And now, how this ties into integrity, which is our second core value of the day, is you can think of integrity is giving someone a high five. You know, even you may have lost your golf match or your basketball game, but still giving someone a high five and saying good job, that's all about integrity and being a good sportsmanship. So I hope you had so much fun learning about our two core values, courtesy and integrity. And I hope you can give this to someone in your family or, you know, maybe one of your friends when you are able to see them next. And we would love if you share your design with us. You can send that and we can always share that with some of our other First Tees participants so they can see as well and get inspired to do this craft and pass on the kindness to other people. and also, happy wacky clothes day. I have two mismatched earrings on and a colorful headband, and my hair is pretty crazy today on top of my very bright orange sweatshirt. I also, not seen, but I also have some pink pants on. So I hope you guys are super comfy and wearing your weirdest wacky outfits today. We'd also love
starting
to see those too.
Makes sense.
Right,
this is the old one.
See you next week, guys.
Awesome. Yes, Coach Sid, thank you so very much for that. That's another very, very cool craft chat going on. People, that is our class for today. You had your golf skill, your craft. Hopefully you practice both the golf skill and you do the craft. And again, when you do it, show us. Put it on our Facebook or any of our social media sites so we can let everybody else know what you're doing.
Definitely. And, you know, if you don't have time for this today, or if you want to go back and review the lessons that Corey talked about today with the golf, or maybe watch his dance party again, these are all up on our website, so you can view those at any time.
Yep, tftco.org. Go to the TFTCO at home button, and you can scroll down and see all of this stuff. Thank you very much, and you have an absolutely wonderful day.
Hi, everyone. Thanks for tuning in.
Bye.